Yeah. So what do we want? Do we want the short version or the medium version? So
your short version is the long version. So let's go with the micro version of that.
Micro version.
Today we have Bryan Koci, Media and Marketing Manager for Whissel Realty Team in San Diego. Bryan has produced over 1,000 videos in the past 4 years, and today he wants to teach you how to become the media mayor of your city.
So again, we were talking earlier and I said, you know, the most people that are listening to this are people in the real estate profession, and a lot of them are my friends. A lot of my friends also know you as well. So I think that this episode is going to be great because there's a lot of people that want to jump into video and they want to do a lot of different things that you and other phenomenal agents are doing across the country, and they just don't know how. And I think that for most of them, they're talking themselves out of it because it's as easy as just putting your phone up to start.
Yes.
But it could definitely can get more advanced and more technical and all these different things. So before we get into the more advanced stuff, what I'm curious to find out is you talked about how you were working at Best Buy and then you landed up here. How exactly did that happen?
Yeah. So what do we want? Do we want the short version or the medium version? So
your short version is the long version. So let's go with the micro version of that.
Micro version. So Kyle is the broker here. He reached out to his agent, said, hey, who knows someone like this? I'm looking for someone to do photos, videos, blah, 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 blah. He reached out to all of his agents. Go ahead. What was it?
What I was going to say is reaching out to the agents. Where's he reaching out?
He talked about it on his social media. We started at one of our Tuesday meetings. We do a meeting every Tuesday with the group, and he said, "Hey guys, this is what I'm looking for. Who knows someone like this?" So one of his agents reached out to me. It's Jared. He's waving at me over there. He reached out and said, "Hey, this is what we're looking for." I met with Kyle, and this medium story shorter, I got hired with Kyle. Is that too short or is that?
It depends who's listening. So you went from Best Buy, then you jumped into here, and from day one,
I had a couple jobs in between.
Got it.
But yeah.
From day one, you started filming Santee Saturdays, East County Eats. You started doing green screen videos, correct? Or no? That was a
close joke. No, pretty
okay.
Close. So I got hired in January. April is when we started Santee Saturdays.
So for somebody that doesn't have a videographer, they don't have anybody in media. They don't know anything about that. And they're looking for somebody. Your piece of advice is what?
So advice to find someone?
Correct.
Or so what I always tell people is I say, hey, look, and this is because this is the background I come from. Look for someone that's in the wedding photography, wedding videography sphere. Don't find the top three in your city because they are going to be busy. But find someone that does, you know, 4, 6, 8 weddings a year. And they're just chilling the rest of the time. Because there's decent money in it and depends on how people live. If you live in a 500 square foot apartment, like when I did when I first started, you didn't have to shoot a lot, right? So the nice thing was I already had all my own gear. I had the understanding of how things worked and then was able to come right into it.
So let me rephrase it just a little bit because I want to make sure that anybody that's listening, they don't kind of brush this over because obviously the first part of hiring somebody is huge. Without getting that person, everything else that we talk about is not going to be applicable. For somebody that doesn't have anybody in the wedding photography space, I'm assuming what you would give as a piece of advice is just start asking people, hey, this is what I'm looking for. And what would be maybe two or three of those bullets that, you know, this type of person that we're looking for, what would those be?
So the thing I always tell people is make sure you hire for attitude, not for aptitude. Ooh, I just used that the first time right now. I like it.
Actually say that one more time.
So hire for attitude, not for aptitude.
Dang. There's a mic drop.
We just dropped right there. So when I first got hired, I was not very good. And that's putting it.
And that's why I asked you the question, hey, did you just instantly jump into green screens and this and this and this and this?
I did. I just didn't do
well. You just weren't as good at it. Got it.
As good as saying I had some skill with it. I wasn't good with it. It was pretty bad. And I remember, I don't think I'll ever forget this. There was Kyle called me into his office and said, hey, look, I know there's a learning curve. It's time to learn it. And I go, oh shit, that's okay, I got it. So, but the more I work within this team, but also with real estate agents all over the country, the more I learn they don't have the time or really the knowledge of what goes into the back end to really say, okay, Bryan, I want you to get some motion graphics. I want you to import them into Premiere. I want you, they don't know the terminology. They don't know what they want. So finding someone that has, that's willing to learn, willing to grow is way more important than someone who already knows what they're doing right now. Finding someone that's a self-starter, the big things we talk about here when we hire, it's Kyle wants people that are humble and hungry. So not someone that comes in that thinks they know it all, because you're not going to grow from there. And someone that's willing to learn and learn and learn. So I learned from the school of YouTube.com. I remember when I first started, it was probably the first week I started, downloaded Premiere, and I searched on YouTube, Adobe Premiere, how to split one clip into two clips. It's literally... We're getting laughed at here. It's literally, I didn't know the terminology.
You're cut. Getting laughed at because I know he's done the exact same thing.
Right? So I didn't know the terminology cut. I didn't know split. I didn't know anything. And so figuring that out from zero to where I'm at now, it's a lot of searching. It's a lot of YouTube. And so that's one thing that the person you hire needs. Now, the other thing that's really important is you as the real estate agent that is hiring this person needs to know that it's going to take time for them to grow. You need to make sure that they're doing the right activities to learn, to grow, and to expand. But you can't expect hiring someone right out of high school or right out of college coming into this and doing stuff like we see Tim Smith do right away. It's just not going to happen. It takes time to grow, and you got to be patient with that. Or you can hire a production crew and spend a butt ton of money, and it's going to look amazing right off the bat, but you're spending a lot more than if you're patient with it.
And I think that it's very key for anybody listening to really rewind it about a few minutes and re-listen to what Bryan's saying. You can have the best videographer. You can have everything that other people are doing if you pay the right amount. Mm-hmm. If you don't want to pay the right amount, then you can still get somebody that's going to be great, but they're not going to be great from day one because they're doing things more than likely they haven't done before.
And to be fair, you as the agent are probably not going to be great day one too.
You're exactly.
Not, I mean, I would love to see.
But what video. I was going to say is anything is better than where you were currently at because you weren't doing any of this.
Absolutely. But I think a lot of people think, okay, I'll hire a videographer and then it'll be great. You got to think, even though you have great, directors of photography and all that sort of stuff in movies, you still have Brad Pitt. Like, it takes two sides to make great pieces of content. You have to have the great video and all that sort of stuff, but you also have to have a great actor. So as you guys grow together, you'll get better and better. I would love to find Kyle's first video and say, look, this is where he started here. This is where he is now. It's a very similar progression to where I first started to where I am now.
Yeah. And I know for sure that when I first started just with a camera in front of me, my wife would always tell me, I know that you are nervous and blah, blah, blah. Because my mouth would literally be like drastically sideways. And I didn't even notice it the entire time. And then you go back and you watch and now it's hilarious. So what you're saying is you might have a good videographer. Maybe it's you that sucks.
I didn't say those words, but yes.
No, I'm kidding. But exactly. You're going to get better. But, to expect that you're going to do some things that you hear others doing or thinking about doing from day one, it's just, not possible. Just like you didn't come into real estate day one and on the first day sell a $1 billion house, yeah. Don't expect that that's going to happen on your media side as well. So you're doing a lot. Okay. And yes. I'm proud of you because you're doing a lot. And there's some things that I don't know exactly how you're doing because you're doing so much.
I got to give props to Tom. Again, Tom is my assistant. We hired him a year ago. Without him, I would not be doing nearly what I'm doing. Before we brought Tom on, my distribution strategy was pretty much upload it to Facebook, hopefully upload it to YouTube, maybe put a title, and we're good to go. Now we've got a whole strategy that we follow with each video, but I only have that time because I brought on another full-time person to shoot and edit as well.
So for anybody listening that wants to do some of the things that he's doing and what they're doing here, you have to realize that it's not just one person that's doing these different things. There's other people.
Also, to be fair, we're doing it for the team. So we're doing a lot of stuff for Kyle, but we're also doing a lot of stuff for the team. So there's 30 agents here at Whissel. And so we're going to photo shoots all over the city. So literally one photo shoot could take us 8 hours between shooting and editing. If we're doing Twilight with drone, with video, all this sort of stuff, then we come back and edit it. So yes, there's two people, but we're also servicing about 30 agents.
Hey, everybody, this is Jonathan Hawkins. Thank you so much for staying until the very end of this podcast. I definitely appreciate it. As always, make sure to reach out to me via social media at Jonathan Hawkins Official. Send me a comment, shoot me a DM. If you have any questions, you can also comment below. Thank you so much. Don't forget to subscribe below. And remember, who you hire truly matters.